This is the offertory part of our church service. And I often think to myself, things have changed so much because of COVID, and yet we're finding different ways of giving. We're finding that even during this offertory, we, you know, sometimes give at the door or we give online, which is, you know, different than we used to do before. And yet there is still so much need for not only things like an offering, but also our skills and our time for our church. And it brings me to think that, you know, we have so much to give, whether it's just in our words or our behaviors or what we do during the day. It makes me think of a story which you've probably heard before, but it is really prevalent today. And as we give our love to others and how we do that in response to God's love to us, helping us feel together again, even when sometimes we're far apart. So bear with me, this story is something close to my heart. Every night, a father tucked his daughter into bed and they would repeat the familiar routine. The little girl would say, "I love you," and her dad would say, "I love you" first. One night, however, the little girl interjected a change. After hearing her father say, "I love you" first, she proclaimed, "I love you always." And that became their new routine. The little girl has grown and now is a young wife and mother, but daughter and father continue to share these words. The exchange continues to affirm their love and connection. One will say, "I love you" first, and then wait and hear the response, "I love you always." You know, this hits close to my heart because my parents are in North Dakota. I haven't seen them physically in a year, and all I want to do is give them a hug. But through my words and through the deeds, we can still show each other how much we love each other. I love you first, and I love you always. As wonderful a gift as the love between a parent and a child, how much greater and more perfect is the love between God, the Creator, and all of us, His children. A God whose love reaches back into all our yesterdays and stretches into all our tomorrows. A God who always loves and forgives, who is always there to guide us when we are lost, to strengthen us when we are tired, and to overwhelm our hearts and love with love and grace, even sometimes when we aren't ready for it. We come today to both acknowledge and praise the one who loves us first and who loves us always. As a church, we give in response to God's love for all of us.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Gracious God, use this money and all that we have for the building up of your work in this church and in the wider world for your glory. Amen.